Political power, it was once said, can bring a man many luxuries, but a clean pair of hands is seldom among them.
You all, in some shape or form, have your hands tainted.
Former State Senator Martin Sandoval wasn't talking about the sprawling corruption scandal in Illinois when he said that, but he could have been. Today,
it is unfortunate.
The 56-year-old's hands are tainted with charges of bribery and tax fraud. A two-page document filed in federal court today says Sandoval, when he was a state senator and chairman of the State Transportation Committee, accepted things of value, namely money, for the continued support of the operation of red light cameras in the state of Illinois, including opposing legislation adverse to the interests of the red light camera industry. And a second count alleges he lied on his tax returns. It states Sandoval made a declaration filed with the Internal Revenue Service that his total income was $125,905, when the defendant knew the total income substantially exceeded that amount.
This is about revenue, not safety. This is a corrupt program.
Republican State Representative David McSweeney tried to pass legislation that would have banned red light cameras, only to see the bill die in Springfield when Sandoval was the powerful chairman of the Senate Transportation Committee.
I passed legislation in 2015 to ban red light cameras. Sandoval killed my bill.
Last fall, federal agents raided Sandoval's home and offices. Just days later, the FBI and IRS also raided government offices in suburban Lyons and McCook, both in Sandoval's district. The corruption investigation is apparently focused in part on SafeSpeed LLC. It's one of the largest red light camera operators in the state. A Chicago Tribune investigation found that Sandoval directly intervened with the Illinois Department of Transportation on behalf of SafeSpeed to install a red light camera at an Oak Brook Terrace intersection, all while receiving thousands from the company in campaign contributions.
I think the U.S. Attorney, John Lausch, is doing an outstanding job. I applaud the efforts of the FBI. I hope they keep going. And we need to get to the bottom of all this. Sandoval is a good first start.
And in a written statement this afternoon, Senate President Don Harmon reacted to these charges, saying, quote, "The searing images of federal agents toting boxes out of the former Senator Sandoval's Capitol office was an embarrassment to all of us who take public service seriously." Sandoval resigned from the Illinois Senate back in November. He is scheduled to be arraigned here in federal court tomorrow at 11 o'clock in the morning. Today, we reached out to his attorney, but have not yet heard back from him. Reporting live this afternoon in The Loop, Mike Lowe, WGN News.